Does anyone really read emails anymore? And how much money do businesses make with email marketing compared to other types of marketing? I'll share some interesting numbers in this video, so hang tight. Hi everyone and welcome. This is the channel for tips on how to attract your audience and convert them into loyal paying customers. I'm Caroline and I've been a copywriter and marketing consultant for nearly 11 years. But enough about me, let's get into today's video. So, is email marketing still a good place to put in your marketing and writing efforts today? Well, the short answer is yes. Email is definitely still a great way to get your content out there in front of your audience and move them down the sales funnel so they become loyal customers. According to Campaign Monitor, in 2020, the average email marketing open rate was 18% across all industries. Think about it. That means even if you have a modest email list of, let's say, 1,000 subscribers, that means 180 people will actually read it, and it doesn't cost you a thing to send out that email to your list. Bonus, all of your list will actually receive your message in their inbox. So if you compare that to the organic reach of social media, for example, if you post something on your Facebook page, you probably know that your content is only going to get in the newsfeed of a small percentage of your followers, right? Now, I'm all for social media, and I definitely think that you should be using these amazing opportunities we have to communicate with our audience on social. And we'll also be talking about how you best present messages on social media on this channel. But my point is here that one strength of email is that your message will actually get to your entire audience. Okay, so here's another statistic for you. According to HubSpot, in 2021, email marketing has a return on investment of 4,200. And that's the average across all industries, by the way. So you might be in an industry with an even higher number. So that means for every dollar you spend on email, you get $42 in return. That's a pretty decent number if you ask me. But you may be thinking, Caroline, I never read all those marketing emails, so I don't think my target audience does either. That is a fair point, and if that's what you're thinking, then I'd like to leave you with two thoughts. First, your email subscribers signed up for your list because they are interested in your topic and the unique way you share your content, and that is why they'll open and read your emails. Second, a common reason why people don't read emails is because they are too filled with sales and messages, or they're just plain boring. But you won't be making this mistake. You'll keep your readers dying to open your emails by sending interesting and valuable content that your audience actually wants to read. But how do you actually write emails that keep the audience just waiting to hear from you? I know, it's easier said than done. Well, for starters, you found this channel where I share lots of little tricks and tweaks you can do to make your emails engaging for your readers. But of course, you need to sell in some of your emails because, let's be honest, you want to make money in your business. So how do you get around that of sending sales emails without losing your readers? The answer is that you should follow the 80-20 rule, which basically just means that 80% of your emails deliver value, like helpful tips related to your product, fun facts and stories they can relate to. And by delivering value most of the time, you'll train your readers to open and enjoy your content, and it'll build that know-like trust factor. So for the last 20% of your emails, when you do send out sales messages such as campaigns or special offers, you can get away with campaign emails without annoying your readers or coming off spammy, because they're used to getting amazing, interesting value from you, and so they trust you as a brand because of that. And so they're open to hearing your sales message when you do decide to send out marketing emails. In this next video, I share the secrets to writing killer email subject lines that will get your readers to actually open your emails with just a few simple tips that you can start using today. So, see you in the next video and have a fantastic day.